going on, guys? Welcome back to Automation, where we wait for the page to load. Anyway, so while we're waiting for this to load, the point of this video today is to make a high-revving, very small V8. And we're going to go ahead and smack it in a ute. We're going to go with this one. Okay, so we are going to make this thing kind of garbage. Surprise. So, this thing's going to be an absolute nightmare, probably. I mean, we'll see. Let's go for straight aluminum. All right, so I kind of just want like an obnoxiously large stroke. Oh, that's so tiny. All right, that looks discount. Let me just say right now that I actually really like the ute. So this isn't intended to just like, you know, trash the ute. I actually love that thing. I just needed some sort of body to put this engine into. And I haven't done anything like that yet. So I just felt like I would do that. Oh, should I just... Yeah, that's probably a terrible idea, but let's see how this goes. Now that could be interesting. Oh, that's so much bigger than the engine. Fuel economy presets. Yes, perfect. Maximum emissions. Let's go with that. Regular gas. Oh my, that does not look nice. I don't think this was designed for something of this size. Alright, so part of the goal here is to get it revving as high as possible. Yeah, let's see if we can hit 12,000. This isn't gonna turn out well. Oh yeah, brilliant. Okay, yeah, there we go. I mean, it's not doing anything over here, but you know, it's trying. What happens if we naturally aspirate this thing? Oh, so basically the turbocharger is the engine. I understand. Get about 92 horsepower out of it. Does it work? It does work though. I mean, it revs pretty high. It just does nothing now. Yeah, I think we're just gonna stick with that. But hey, now we can knock this thing up to 12,000. It's just dying in the background. Yeah, I don't really foresee her giving us a lot more to work with here. Anyway, all right, let's design this thing. Oh, it's beautiful, isn't it? Let's make that long. You know, the more I look at it, the more I just absolutely hate that grill. We're gonna just... Oh, that's not bad. Okay, yeah, we're gonna go with that. What do I want to put on this? How about some pop-ups? No, I'm not doing that. I do pop-ups way too frequently. We're gonna actually, you know, do something normal here. Just kind of bizarre. I mean, like, if I wanted to, like, you know, just kind of do something normal, I feel like these headlights right here are the first step in accomplishing that. I mean, to be fair, I have made quite a bit worse than this, so technically we're off to a good start here. Wait a second, this isn't the right body type. Not that it really makes a difference, they're all just exactly the same. There we go. That looks menacing. What if I made this taller? Yeah, that's not bad. Oh, we could do one of these things. This is going to take me forever. Letters in this game are not fun. Yeah, that's good enough. I'm not gonna worry about perfection on the letters and stuff, just because, you know, at the time that this car came out, pretty standard to have hood gaps you could, you know, fit your hand through. So, I'm not too concerned about a little bit of not super level lettering. All right, so we're gonna make this thing a 4x4. Let's not fantasize here. It's not reaching 150 miles an hour. We'll go with drums. That should work fine. All right, I think that we're gonna call this done here. 113 horsepower. Let's see how this thing performs. All right, let's give this thing a test. So the only real problem with it so far that it's just like obviously standing out to me is that it's a little higher than I would have liked. I went back in and messed with it, but I just can't get it any lower. I think it just has to do with the body type, but it's whatever. Let's see how it goes. That suspension is rigid. Oh my. There is no... This thing is rigid. Okay, it is so many RPMs. This is not terrible performance for these numbers. At least in my opinion. Jeez. That thing just bounces in the back. It's such a hard suspension. Well, we just power slide in a straight line. Alright, this seems to have, like, somewhat become a routine test, so let's just throw it through this thing. Oh, that was weird. Otherwise, not bad. Again, it's not bad. It's just a little odd. Okay, steering-wise, yeah, we got some major understeer issues. But, it's not awful. Could have been substantially worse. Let's see, can we make this? Definitely not at 55, but let's find out. Oh. Oh. Yeah, I'll consider that a win. Let's give it some off-road tests, shall we? I mean, it could be worse. It definitely isn't gonna be a comfortable ride, but it will get through it. Oh boy, okay. Yeah, let's give this a go. Well, that went well, I'd say. I'm not optimistic about this. So it appears that our options are kind of plunge headfirst into the way too deep water, or be stuck here for all eternity. Yeah, I'm not good at mudding even with a good car for the job. So this is just extra difficult for me. I know that you're not supposed to just sit and dig holes, but I don't think this is spin tires is what I'm trying to say. Oh yeah, we made it through. Heck yeah. Alright, here we are at the track. So, I don't expect this to be a fast lap time. I kind of expect this to be near the bottom. Maybe just above the Gran Turismo. I really don't think anything's gonna perform worse than the Gran Turismo. But, yeah, I don't expect it to be a stellar lap time here. It's got, like, 120 or so horsepower. Thing weighs about as much as a building. So, yeah, not too high hopes on the time here, but, I guess we'll see. Anyway, 3, 2, 1, go. It's got a decently quick launch for its low numbers. Like, fair performance on this thing. It is actually handling this stuff very nicely. Like, I didn't give this car a test lap either because I didn't feel like taking the time. I just figured if I screwed up on this, I'd just restart the lap and pretend like it didn't happen, but it's handling itself pretty nice. Like, it's accelerating through these corners nicely. It's hugging the turns nicely. It's actually not doing that bad. Alright, I'm not sure how to gauge this here, but alright, that seemed okay. Alright, not the straight, so we're gonna hit, like, what, 70 maybe? Oh, no, we actually might have had an 80 top speed, but I'm a little scared about how it's gonna handle cornering at high speed, so I wanna slow us down. Let's get through this corner. It does have a tendency to understeer, but, besides that, it's being pretty predictable. Alright, this felt pretty quick, actually. Like, all things considered, for this car, this isn't bad. Okay, that was a little slower than I would have liked, but going to the final stretch and across the line. Alright, so the official time for the Wallaby is a 1:53.24. So yeah, it definitely is toward the bottom of this, which is what I expected, but it did handle itself quite nicely. It wasn't as far down as I was actually expecting it to be. I was expecting it to be a much more substantial difference from the rest of the pack. But hey, it held itself pretty nicely, and we're getting a ridiculous amount of frame skips over here. I don't know why that is. But yeah, all in all, this thing didn't turn out too badly. I mean, for a car that weighs exceedingly large amounts of weight, that was profound, and revs up to 12,000 RPM, I mean, this thing ain't bad. But yeah, anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, let me know. I'm planning something a little special for the upcoming days, so you're gonna wanna stay tuned for that. But I do wanna finish out a few more car builds before I do this special thing that I am talking about. I don't wanna give away too much as to what it is yet, but I will say that it involves all the cars that have already been made, and I'm going to include two more cars that haven't been made yet. So once we hit 10 cars, I'm gonna make a special
involving all 10 cars. So keep your eyes out for that. We got a little ways left to go before we're gonna do that. But I think that's gonna be a really fun episode, and I'm looking forward to making that and seeing what you guys think of it. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I will see you guys in the next one.